We are here today assembled to send a very strong message to the CEOs in the rail industry. And that is that the American people are sick and tired of the type of corporate greed we are seeing in that industry. At a time of record-breaking profits, that industry can and must guarantee at least 7 paid sick days to every rail worker in America. In the year 2023, that is not a whole lot to ask. Last year, 6 rail companies, Union Pacific, BNSF, Canadian Pacific, Canadian National, Norfolk Southern, and Kansas City Southern, made more than $22 billion in profits. They are doing extremely well. And what did they do with those record-breaking profits? Did they spend it on making the rail industry safer? And we just saw the other day this terrible accident in Ohio. No, they did not do that. Did they spend that money on improving the horrendous working conditions that exist today in the rail industry? Is that where they invested their money? No, they didn't do that. They spent over $20 billion of their profits on stock buybacks and dividends to make their wealthy shareholders even wealthier. And get this, and this is an important point to make. The $20 billion these rail companies spent on stock buybacks and dividends is $5 billion more than they spent on wages and benefits for their entire workforce. Meanwhile, at a time when the rail industry slashed 30% of its workforce over a 6-year period, the CEOs of these 6 rail companies made over $175 million in compensation over a 3-year period. Record-breaking profits, CEOs making out like bandits, workers not getting 1 paid sick day. Now, that may make sense to somebody. It does not make sense to me. Let us be clear. Guaranteeing 7 paid sick days to rail workers would cost the entire industry just $321 million, less than 1.2% of their profits in a single year. And they tell us they cannot afford sick days. In my view, if the industry can afford to spend over $20 billion on stock buybacks and hand out huge dividends to their wealthy shareholders, they can afford to provide rail workers with at least 7 paid sick days. And they also can afford to end once and for all the disastrous Wall Street-pushed, precision-scheduled railroad system that has made life so difficult for workers throughout the industry. Here is some very good news, and that is a couple of days ago, thanks to the work of the people behind me and workers all over this country, CSX, one of the major rail companies, finally agreed to provide paid sick days to some 5,000 rail workers in our country. Yesterday, I sent a letter to the CEOs of the other major rail companies demanding that they do the same. Now, all of you know the history of legislation in terms of what happened just a few months ago, and that is in November. The U.S. House passed legislation guaranteeing 7 paid sick days to every rail worker in America. In December, a majority in the U.S. Senate, including Senator Braun and myself, all Democrats plus 1 and 6 Republicans, voted for this legislation. Unfortunately, the bill was filibustered in the Senate by a minority of senators and did not become law. Well, I have news for executives in the rail industry. If they think that those of us in Congress who voted for 7 days paid sick days for workers are going to forget this issue, they got it wrong. We are not going to forget this issue. Now, I hope that the companies, that the corporations do the right thing. I hope they do it voluntarily, and we're making some progress. If they don't, I look forward to seeing them right here in this Senate committee room to tell us why they cannot afford to do the right and moral things for their workers. So let me just conclude. We're making some progress. We got a long way to go. I know the Biden administration is working on this as well. But at the end of the day, in the year 2023, it is not acceptable to me and to the overwhelming majority of the American people that workers who do dangerous, difficult, and important work do not get one paid sick day a year off. So with that, let me now introduce Adam West, who is a CSX conductor and Smart TD member from Lafayette. Oh, no, let me introduce Senator Mike Braun. I'm sorry, Mike. Come on up here.
Adam, good to have you here from my home state. This was an easy issue for me. I grew up in southern Indiana, a place that a lot of blue dog Democrats, everybody in my hometown couldn't tell the difference between a blue collar and a white collar worker, loaded with entrepreneurs, loaded with workers, based on, I think, that kind of ideal that we should all aspire to. I decided to not go to Wall Street many, many years ago, moved back to my hometown, took a significant pay cut because I wanted to raise a family and maybe start a business. Well, my wife did the same thing. She's had her own business in our downtown now for her only job as a career. I can tell you one thing. If you treat your employees like family, if you do what I'm proud of, in the lowest unemployment county generally in the state of Indiana, where you pay the highest wage and you get good benefits, people come to your place to work and they stay there over time. So it's not a complicated formula, and a union is simply when you're going vis-a-vis these huge companies. I come from Main Street. My little company had 15 employees for 17 years. And then over the last 20, 25 years, we've expanded across the country. And that same approach, treating employees like family, taking care of what's common sense. When I heard that you didn't have a guaranteed sick day, I wondered how could you get by with that in this day and age? You don't know when you're going to get sick. It's going to be an issue on keeping employees long term. Wasn't hard for me to get on that issue. And where I come from, again, most of this stuff should be natural. And if you do it, it's in the best interest of your own company long term. When it comes to this dichotomy in our country between one like mine, which is a Main Street business, where I say openly, did it 8, 9 years ago when I was awarded the entrepreneur of the area. And I said, hey, as all business owners, if you want to make life easy in the long run, make sure you take care of your employees. You got customers, you got employees, and in my case, never had a board of directors because the business was so little, and now 3 of my 4 kids work in it, and we're proud of that. When I hear CEO pay, for instance, that's maybe 50 times, and sometimes it's more than that, of an average employee, I would never do that, and I think for anybody that does do that, you're going to look at issues that might even be broader than what we're talking about here today. So I think it is, when it comes down to common sense stuff like this, and Senator Sanders said, it looks like the industry may get this worked out. That's ideally the way it should be done. When you got big companies, collective bargaining is there for that reason. And you should not have to scrap for sick days the way we all know it, with no preconditions, not conditional. So I'm hoping, too, this solves itself through the network of common sense. Looks like it's already happening. Kudos to everyone that brought it to the forefront. And I, as a Main Street business owner, will always weigh in on this stuff because it shouldn't be blue collar or white collar. It should be common sense.
Vince Verna is the vice president of the Brotherhood of Locomotive Engineers and Trainmen. Vince.
Thank you, Senator Sanders, and thank you, Senator Braun. The BLET is the oldest continuously operating union in the United States, founded in 1863, just weeks before the Gettysburg Address. Our union is American as Abraham Lincoln and has proudly helped build the middle class in America. This year also marks our 20th anniversary as part of the Teamsters Union, and we're proud of that. Our members are world-class employees, and they're literally the vertebrae who make up the spine that is the railroad that keeps this economy moving. Locomotive engineers and trainmen go to work not on a schedule, but by being on call. They're subject to call 24/7, 365 days a year. Most of them never show up to work at the same time, 2 days in a row. They literally work at the railroad's beck and call. They deserve better treatment than they are getting from the railroads right now when they are sick, and they need time off when they're sick. Right now, employees know you'd better not get sick. If you do, you'll be subject to harsh employee attendance policies that do not allow you to take off sick without fear of reprisal. These railroad policies literally add insult to the illness of our members. Some railroads want 30 days notice to take a sick day. Nobody plans to get the flu. Nobody plans to get COVID. And as we all know from no one plans to get shingles because shingles doesn't care. We know that from the ad. But they need to have time off when they find themselves sick that day. We definitely applaud the efforts of Senator Sanders for calling for 7 paid sick days. Locomotive engineers and trainmen need them. A locomotive engineer's work takes them out of town for days at a time. The railroads really must now accommodate their employees' needs when they are sick. The railroad CEOs would never work under the conditions they require their workers when making them choose between their jobs and their health. Right now, it was said before, we're engaged in collective bargaining on the issue, and we hope we can find a fix in the negotiation. So far and for far too long, it's been a stubborn issue that we have not been able to get any movement. If it does not, we will continue to pursue legislation and regulation to ensure America's freight gets moved by workers who are not sick on the job. So let's get this fixed, and thanks again to Senator Sanders.